all this love I have to give her. I guess I'm gonna stay with her while.
WRLR 98.3 FM.
Hoorah! Oh yeah!
Here we are, Tuesday night again at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
Ted Schneider, Bob Slipke here. Your info explorers trying to figure out what the hell's going on. It is amazing when you look at all the information sources out there. It's like two different worlds.
Three different worlds.
One group of information sources. Everything's fine. Don't worry about a thing. It's business as usual. The other group of information sources is like the world is ending. Aliens are about to invade us. It's like run, panic, scream. Ah!
But you know what? It's the world we live in, Bob.
That's right. That's why we're picking out stuff that we think will be interesting to you. But like all information, you got to decide who's saying it, who's paying them, and then what are they saying? I mean,
exactly.
A lot, 80% of the information out there is all opinion journalism, and 20% or less is actual hard journalism, hard facts, things that are happening.
So if you watch sports, usually that's pretty much online.
That's, yeah, right. You can't put too many opinions in
they
sports.
They scored a touchdown or they didn't.
That's right, yeah. If a tornado hit a town, it definitely hit it or it missed it. You're going to see the evidence.
But even in sports, think about how they pick on the coach and all their opinion of these players.
Oh, God almighty.
And then Gruden with his email. So now it's
how many years ago?
Yeah, but how long, you know, so again, it's no longer just football and the coach. They dig deeper and deeper and deeper.
Yeah. There's people out there with nothing to do but except destroy other people's lives.
But I would hope he's got a few bucks in the bank after he's been coaching in the NFL for 30 years. So.
You know, I tell you what, it's just to the point of being ridiculous. People are going to say things years ago that it don't matter now. What's the guy thinking right now? We've all got skeletons in the closet.
Well, Bob, your best bet is to eliminate anybody that might have seen
that's
what you
right.
said
yeah.
or did years ago.
That's right. That's why the black hand.
No, just, you know, and that's why the beauty of us growing up in a world with no cell phones, no cameras.
No cameras, no cell phones, no text messages. We could have got away. We did get away with a
exactly.
lot of stuff.
Go ahead and prove it.
Yeah.
Right. But anyway.
Now, jeez, forget it. You can't even go to the bathroom without somebody videotaping you.
Exactly. And then, Bob, you know what? I've got some videos of me using the bathroom if you want to.
Oh, my God. Please.
I will pass them on
Jesus.
To you.
Jesus.
But as Bob mentioned, this is the Info Explorer radio show on WRLR 98.3 FM, coming to you live in the Round Lake Beach Metro Station every Tuesday from 7 to 9. And we always start our show out with well, the intro, and then, of course, the station ID. Let me do the
lighthearted comments.
Yeah, I hope. Yeah, let me do the local loyal listeners. And Zach Schneider, we thank you very, very much for listening. My youngest offspring, Alec, my middle offspring, thank you for listening as well. Of course, we've got a host of people, and we do appreciate Ellen, you listening as well, and a host of other people. Again, we would sit here all day if we just listed everyone who listens. But I also want to just start something off, Bob. It's interesting how the world works today. Technology, just a quick side note. So I'm driving here about 70 miles an hour.
Oh, my God. I'm Washington? It's a 35, dude. Yeah. But,
now, on the tollway. So I'm basically keeping up with traffic, and all of a sudden I hear the sound go off that my teams, someone sent me a message, because they think I'm in the office, because, of course, it's on my phone, so it looks like I'm active. Ooh, so I'm thinking, so how am I going to answer him, since I don't usually use that app? Well, I've got Lane Assist on my Honda. So I hit the little menu button, hit Lane Assist, and it basically drives the car inside the lanes. All you have to do is every 10 seconds touch the wheel. So I let the car drive at 70 miles an hour. I actually responded back on Teams, and then I called them. But meanwhile, I had all I had to do is the car tells you when to touch the steering wheel. So all I had to do is touch it a little bit, and it continues to go. So the technology keeps the car like a Tesla in between, even when around curves. It goes around curves because it follows the white lines. So I was telling my daughter that. She goes, "Kind of sounds dangerous, Dad." I'm like, "I know, but that's the appeal."
All right, so what kind of flowers you like at your funeral?
Yeah,
so anyway, fiery car crash on 294.
So I love
many injured, or was it one person that's in many parts? We don't know.
And his phone was burned in his hand.
That's right. The only thing left of the driver was his hand and his phone.
So cool technology that basically drive the car by itself at 70 miles an hour while I attended to business
until somebody shuts it off.
Exactly.
What if there was a power failure, an EMT blast from Chinese? Troops in our area.
Or some big fireworks.
Yeah, you don't know. You got to be careful.
Either way. But anyway, I throw that out there, Bob. I love technology. It was kind
of fun. When I was growing up, we used to drive our cars.
Yeah, I know, but and this is a inexpensive car, relatively speaking. It's not some high-end Tesla or Mercedes. So anyway, just keep that in mind. But our first article, 15 worst foods for high cholesterol at eatthis.com. Lauren Manacker. MS, RDN, yeah, she's an MS, so she has multiple sclerosis. She RDN, she's in some kind of rash down on her, anyway. And then LD, which is light dermatology problems. And then CLEC. Anyway, eatthis.com. And Bob, didn't we have somebody on here? What was it called? Remember that show with the people ahead of us? Wasn't it called Eat This or...
Eat This. That was many years ago.
It was a husband and wife.
It was husband and wife team.
Wasn't it called Eat This?
I thought it was.
Yeah, anyway.
Wow.
Anyway, think of their names.
Old there, Ted. I don't remember.
Yeah, we digress. So, Bob, is your cholesterol under control or no?
I have no idea.
Okay, well, you should find out. But either way, if you do have high cholesterol, here's 15 foods you should avoid. It was Patty. Patty and Mike?
Patty and Mike.
And I think we call it Now Eat This or Eat This Now or Eat This. It was a cooking show, too, I might add.
That's the way they were describing our show, I think it was. Your show stinks.
But it was Patty and Mike. Yeah, Eat This. Anyway, I think it was called Eat This.
I got your show right here.
Yeah, this is eatthis.com. So, number one, Bob, coconut oil has been a hot topic.
Oh, no.
Yes, and it sounds healthy, but it's not the best fat choice when it comes to cholesterol management.
According to all you people living out on those islands, put the coconuts down.
Yeah. Coconut and palm fat is high in saturated fat, so keeping these food choices to a minimum is important.
Wow.
So get off the coconut oil, Bob.
Mm.
What else is bad for your high cholesterol?
Bacon. Oh, my God. Bacon's in everything. If you have a lousy meal, throw bacon on it. I mean, that's your last choice.
Mm.
I made sundaes the other day, and they tasted terrible, so I threw bacon on it. Everybody loved them.
Yeah.
So anyways, Mr. Palmer.
Yeah, Palmer is a, hold on a second, who is he?
Arnold Palmer shares that foods high in saturated fat, like bacon and other fatty meats, should be avoided when managing high cholesterol.
I'm going to cut that out. He was probably a doctor.
Plant-based protein sources are a better choice Like these 26 best vegetarian sources of protein.
Well, I cut that article out. So
oh, geez, and that's exactly why I'm reading this. And you cut it out.
You got to look ahead, Bob. You got to look ahead.
For showtime limits, we can't talk about a critical part of this article.
No, no, no. You want to know about... Bob, you want 26 best vegetarian sources of protein? Look it up.
Look it up.
My God.
Get off your lazy butt.
I got to do everything here.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
You know, Bob, and my kids say, is it heavy carrying Bob? I go, yeah, it is. But fatty pork sausage, Bob.
Fatty pork sausage. She was a producer on this show, wasn't she?
Yeah, fatty pork.
We had her come on a couple of times.
Yeah, her name is Ms. Fatty Pork.
Fatty pork sausage. Oh, she could cook. Oh, my God.
But she was a big woman. Yeah, she was a big woman. She wasn't fat. She was a big woman.
Yeah, big, strong woman.
Oh, yeah. She actually lifted. She was in that powerlifting competition.
That's right. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, in the Olympics. I think it was for Germany.
Yeah, she was out here throwing those couches around out here. Like,
yeah, well, she was upset because we didn't give her more than 10 minutes. Remember that day? Anyway, fatty pork products like certain sausages should be extremely limited when managing high cholesterol. I would think salt would be big up there too, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think that's part of it.
Yeah, so watch out for the fatty pork sausage.
All right.
What else, Bob, is bad for high cholesterol?
White bread.
White bread?
So it's white. It's got to be bad.
Yeah.
You just talk to anybody on the
South Side. What's wrong with white bread?
Among the foods that people with high cholesterol should avoid, refined carbohydrates such as white bread are one of the most important. Instead, opt for fiber-rich foods like whole grain bread and whole wheat pasta. Speaking of carbs, are you aware of the 8 side effects of eating too many carbs? Well, yes, I am interested. Where's that article, Ted? Oh, you threw that out, too. What, are you working for the government?
Click on the link. Hit the page. Click on it.
I feel like I'm in a committee meeting at the House of Representatives.
Well, but I made this short so I would keep your attention span. Because I know how you just kind of... Yeah, you kind of just like...
All right.
But, you know, I never heard of whole wheat... So you would make a sandwich with whole wheat pasta? How's that going to work?
No. You use whole wheat pasta. You don't make bread out of it.
Gotcha. So what else, Bob, is bad for high cholesterol? Frozen pizza.
God, this is like somebody went into my refrigerator.
I know. I'm thinking, too. According to Teresa Gentile, is that Gentile? Gentile?
Where's it?
Gentile. Teresa Gentile.
Gentile.
I like Gentile. She's an MS and an RDN, a Brooklyn-based registered dietitian, says those with high cholesterol should avoid foods with trans fats.
Trans fats. That's like every fast food place you can think of.
It raises your bad and lowers your good cholesterol, Bob. So be careful of some of those frozen pizzas. What else, Bob, is bad for high cholesterol? According to Lauren
Moniker. Ribeye steak. Yeah.
Ribeye?
That's the fattier parts of the meat that I'm thinking.
Unless
here.
You had the cow that worked out.
Yeah. So
grapefruit, Bob, grapefruit. If you're taking certain cholesterol-lowering drugs, grapefruit can be one of the worst foods you can eat. Not because it may increase cholesterol, because it can negatively interact with your medication.
Oh, my God.
So if you're on a cholesterol-lowering drug, talk to your doctor, and maybe you need to get off of the grapefruit.
Cholesterol-lowering drug, is that a statin?
I do not know.
All right. Statins are...
Like the island?
Start looking for the side effect results on statin drugs. That would be a good start.
So let's hold on a second, Bob. We'll find out. What's an example of a cholesterol-lowering drug?
According to Cleveland Clinic, statins are one of the better-known types of cholesterol-lowering drugs.
Right you are, Bob.
Increase cholesterol output by blocking the HMG-CoA reductase enzyme that the liver uses to
we'll
make cholesterol.
Yeah, thank you. Okay.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. She's all eating right. up our showtime.
Well, okay, well, so you asked, Bob, and, you know, so
that's
she wanted...
Right. Movie theater popcorn. Oh, my God, my life is being destroyed here.
Yeah, popcorn and movie viewing go together like peanut butter and jelly, but many popcorns made outside of the home are loaded with saturated fats and have oodle of healthy, heart-healthy fats. Opt for air pop, but just bring your own, Bob. Sneak a bag in your pants.
Well, I tell you what, I just don't get the buttered popcorn anymore.
What do you get, caramel corn?
Water and popcorn. It sounds like prison food, but that's enough.
And I heard that is no longer a problem if you have diverticulitis. Popcorn, seeds, nuts.
Really?
Yeah, now they're saying no. I mean, not many years ago, they told me after my first colonoscopy.
Don't eat popcorn.
Don't be, And I was like, you know what?
You know, it's like everybody changes their tune after a few years.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's like this whole flu thing going on right now. Now... who knows? They'll change their tune. Oh, you don't need the shots. We've got pills now.
I'm like,
I'm not sure about those pills, but
you know.
Anyway,
I'm back. Not getting excited about anything anymore.
Don't get excited, Bob. At your age, you're getting kind of old.
That's right.
Yeah, we should probably do a station ID.
Oh, no.
So people know who we are. What station?
What?
We're on.
Who?
Go ahead. You got it.
Who did?
Go ahead. You got it.
WRLR 98.3 FM.
For those that just joined, or those that have poor memory, or those that have other learning disabilities.
Something more important to do.
Yeah, this is Bob and Ted.
Sleep on a couch.
On WRLR 98.3 FM, the voice of Lake County, the Info Explorers. We're doing 15 worst foods for high cholesterol. Bob, what's after movie theater popcorn?
One. Regular soda. I don't drink soda.
Pop is off the list.
You know, I tell you, if I do drink anything kind of on the goofy side, it's usually bourbon, but other than that, it's like, or scotch, or vodka. Maybe I have another kind of problem. Yeah. I don't know here. But
is that considered goofy or just alcohol, Bob?
Yeah. No, I'm drinking a lot healthier now. I'm staying away from that soda, but I'm drinking everything else.
Yeah. No, that's true. But data suggests that as sugar intake increases, your HDL cholesterol, the good cholesterol, decreases while the triglycerides increase. Well, So bottom line, I would stay off of pop anyway.
Yeah, because they call pop liquid cookies. So I'm
nope. What else? Butter.
Butter. Oh, my God. You may want to go easy on butter when you are trying to lower your cholesterol. Enjoy alternatives like extra virgin olive oil, which I do.
Yeah, but can you imagine extra virgin oil, olive oil on like your English muffin?
Actually, if you season it right, you could use a little avocado oil. Okay. Your English muffin with a little turmeric seasoning.
How about olive oil? Brutus.
No, there are alternatives. But I tell you what, the whole issue here is, what is a good cholesterol level that this article doesn't bring up? What is considered now normal?
Well, plus it's the good and the bad you got to weigh out
right.
What the ratio is.
And then everybody's a little different. Some people can live with high cholesterol just for a few minutes longer, but...
Some people look at butter and die. Honey, no.
Don't put that butter on my... Oh.
So can you imagine that? So then the police come. What happened? I don't know.
Even butter.
I found him dead on the floor. Yeah. All you have to do is wave bacon in front of somebody, and they have a heart attack or a stroke.
Hey, that's how they can get all the unvaccinated people to get vaccinated. Offer them bacon.
Yeah. Want some bacon?
Yeah, we'll give you a pound of bacon if you get this vaccine.
Or how about some buttered bacon with a side of Coke? Coca-Cola, that is.
The chicken wings.
Chicken wings.
Oh, God almighty.
Alec, did you hear that? Chicken wings are often fried, several with a fatty skin on, and tossed in a sauce made of melted butter and spice.
And poison.
A trifecta of cholesterol-raising factors. So next time you go for those wings, Alec, you might want to check where it's made. You want to ask them for baked and skinless wings. And sprinkle them with...
Hit the road, boy.
And maybe a salt-free dry rub. Now, why would you dry rub your
wings? Dry rub your chickens.
Alec, do not... Zach, when you go with Alec for the wings, make sure he doesn't try to dry rub them. That doesn't sound good at all, does it?
And it probably doesn't look good at the table either.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, what's that man doing over there?
I think
he's rubbing that chicken. Don't look.
He's dry rubbing it. You see sparks? Oof.
The chicken's then chop. The kid chicken's dead.
So be careful with chicken wings. I would ask them again, baked and skinless, next time you go. What
sure,
else, Bob?
Sure, buddy.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Get out of here.
Yeah, these are baked and they're also skinless. Here you go.
Yeah. One, now leave.
Yeah. What else is bad for your
biscuits?
Cholesterol?
Oh, French fries.
Well, French fries, you knew that, Bob. Come on. Fried foods also increase your risk of prostate cancer.
It
fried foods, period.
And what they're fried in.
No, fried foods, boom.
But air frying is a lot cleaner.
With the pollution we have? Are you kidding me? Air frying probably is deadly.
You know, you hold a French fry up in the sky, if it's nuked and something's wrong with the air, or you're too close to a telecommunications tower.
Well, that's like people hit like fish. How much mercury is in those things, right?
Man, I don't know.
And if it comes from the West Coast, it was probably swimming in waters that Fukushima had spilled out.
What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah.
So
anyway, I'm just saying.
Think about that. Can you cook a French fry if you stand too close to a 5G tower?
I don't know.
We'll have to do an experiment.
That might be something. But I guess, can you air fry French fries?
Yeah.
Have you tried it?
Yeah.
How's it taste?
Excellent.
All right, maybe you're okay.
That is greasy. They're great. Air fryers, it's just what it says it is. And I'll tell you what, I've done dumplings. I've done gnocchi. I've done biscuits. I've done...
One of our listeners just sent his picture of... thank you, Alec. He sent a picture of...
what he's eating right now.
Chicken wings. So apparently, he doesn't care. All right. So we continue.
Shut up, Dad. I'm eating. Leave me alone.
We're on 15 worst foods for high cholesterol. Pie crust. So it's your secret family recipe for pie crust calls for lard. Skip it. Lard is one of the worst things you can eat. Well, why would you eat lard? Is lard in pie crust?
Well, actually, one of our friends is an excellent fisherman.
And he
uses lard to fry his fish. And it comes out great. I can't believe it.
Bob's going to take a nap and back in 10.
Yeah, I'm going to take a nap and think of those fish.
No, but here it says, so we can go get a pie and ask them if they put lard in the crust?
No. Well, yeah, I guess so. But what's an alternative for lard?
Well, I'm glad you asked, Bob. Try crushed graham crackers.
Oh, my God.
Or go crustless. How would you go crustless?
You just use the aluminum pan. Just
I guess. Yeah. And then lastly, Bob, if you want to get cut down on high cholesterol, what should you avoid? Artificial sweeteners. Calorie-free sweeteners may add some flavor, but using them is linked to a higher incidence of obesity, hypertension, metabolic syndrome, type 2 diabetes.
Races and homophobia.
And birth defects.
Or death.
Death. If you use artificial sweeteners...
You will die.
Yeah, what was that, saccharin? Remember that? It was like a glass container. You had a few drips. Remember that?
Yeah.
That was net. Yeah. That looked weird, right? It was like liquid, remember? Like water? And a couple drips. Like you shook it twice.
If you got to walk away from the media once in a while because you watch all these fear stories. It's all fear porn one way or another.
Fear porn.
You know, it's like...
Bob, you've been watching fear porn.
I would love to see a meteor hit the Earth tomorrow so we can put an end to all this. Finally. Well, you were right and we are all dead.
Would it kill everybody or just part of the planet?
It's only going to kill the Democrats.
Is that it? A meteor? Gotcha. Well, Bob,
meteor from God.
That was 15 foods to avoid if you have high cholesterol, according to Lauren Menacker.
Oh.
At eatthis.com. We should do a little music between the things.
Forget it.
Well, this
we're going to start another topic here. I just want to let you all know.
Yeah, InfoExplorer Radio Show with Bob Slipke and Ted Schneider on WRLR 98.3. Adam Evans at lifehack.org says 7 reasons why your body feels heavy and tired. Now, Bob,
been working on the car engine and it fell on you.
Yeah. Or you're old and you're fat.
That
would make you heavy and tired, but no.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you, Bob, you ever feel heavy and tired?
All the time.
Well, maybe it's because of lack of sleep. This is quite possibly one of the main reasons why people feel heavy and are tired.
Wow.
I often feel like a broken record explaining to people the importance of quality sleep and REM. So, Bob, number one, lack of sleep could make you feel tired and heavy. Number two, according to Adam Evans at lifehack.org.
Lack of exercise.
Yep.
Huh. Yeah, I'll tell you what, after a light workout, where I'm running all over the place like a nut,
like a knuckle.
In and out of cars, up and down stairs, moving things around, I actually feel pretty good. I feel a little charged, but boy, I tell you, you got to maintain a certain level of activity. Otherwise, you got to climb back up the stairs to get to that level. So you got to do it.
That's true. So lack of sleep, lack of exercise, poor nutrition and hydration, Bob, can make you tired and heavy or feel heavy. The human body is primarily composed of water, up to 60%. So naturally, a lack of hydration will deplete energy, according to studies.
Especially in the brain.
The brain and the heart are 73% water, and the lungs are about 83%. So that's why you have water in the lungs, right? 83% water.
Yeah.
Skin is 64%. Bottom line, Bob, proper nutrition. And you need to watch excess sugar.
We are what we eat, folks.
Yeah, consuming too much sugar can harm the body and the brain. Hasn't hurt me. It causes short bursts of energy, followed by mental fogginess. Anyway, so watch out for your sleep. Watch out for your nutrition, hydration, exercise. What else, Bob, can make you feel
stress.
Tired and heavy?
Yes. Stress is surprisingly overlooked in our fast-paced society. Well, that's because we're too damn busy.
I ain't got time.
To even look at it.
I ain't got time. Keep going. Keep going. Stress. I have stress.
So, yeah. But the stress has been shown to affect all systems of the body.
Hmm.
Everything.
Everything.
We're all screwed up.
Well, Bob, number five is depression or anxiety. These two often go hand in hand with stress. It's overlooked, though, much in our society. Millions upon millions around the work experience symptoms of symptoms of depression and anxiety. Many that are depressed report symptoms of lack of energy, enthusiasm, and generally not even wanting to get up from bed in the morning. So it's a real thing, Bob, for some people, depression and or anxiety.
And I tell you what, wearing these stupid masks at work doesn't help either.
Well, but, you know, you look better with a mask on, Bob. You do. You know, you look younger. You look more alluring.
You look pretty with a mask on, Bob.
Bob, you look pretty. And we have WRLR masks now, right?
That's right. These are beautiful things, and next time I go rob a bank, I'll make sure I'm wearing mine.
Yeah, so that...
Oh, gosh, where are you from? This is a radio program, not a robbery.
I want to do a live broadcast from the bank.
We're going to simulate a robbery. This is totally entertainment only.
Yeah, for entertainment purposes, no one was actually harmed in the
put all that money in these bags. Make sure you smile towards the camera and look scared.
And don't touch those buttons. Don't give me a dye pack either.
That's right.
Hypothyroidism.
Whatever that is.
It's also known, Bob, as underactive thyroid disease. Hypothyroidism is a health condition where the thyroid gland doesn't produce sufficient levels. What does your thyroid gland produce, you know? Thyroid oil, right?
Thyroid oil.
I don't know.
Can we cook with that?
Yes, you can. But anyway, Bob, it causes the metabolism to slow down. Well, I don't have hypo. I have, like, hyper. I can eat anything, Bob, and I don't gain weight. Hmm. Could be the 18 fiber pills I take every day, too. And Bob, number seven.
Well, this is my fault.
Of the reasons your body feels heavy and tired.
I'm writing this as someone that went from 5 cups of coffee a day to now 3 cups a week. Oh, you must have been a real bear changing over to that.
5 cups a day to 3 a week?
Oh, my God.
He's probably in therapy for that.
Jesus, he's probably, they're still pulling his fingers out of the wall.
He's chained downstairs in the basement.
Yeah, stay away from him on a full moon.
Yeah.
He goes for the coffee, so stay the hell out of the kitchen.
But, Bob, why did this author stop consuming so much coffee?
I don't know. I'd be too nervous to do that. I'd keep drinking probably more.
Well, read a little further, Bob. It'll tell us. The reason he stopped consuming is that it was affecting his mood and energy level.
Ah.
Now, did Bob, drinking too much coffee, does it affect your mood or energy level?
I don't know. No, nobody comes near me when I drink too much coffee.
Right. But generally, excessive consumption of caffeine can also impact the adrenal gland, which, as he covered above, can be lead to low energy and random energy crashes. Can you imagine a random energy crash as you're, like, running in a race?
Oh, my God.
And you just collapse. Or let's say you're walking to work and... Or you're talking to someone on the phone, right? So, Bob, bottom line, if you feel heavy and tired and you're not old and heavy or old and big or overweight, it could be one of these things, according to Adam Evans at lifehack.org. You know, we should probably...
5 cups of... How big were the cups?
Well, maybe they were...
I got like a...
A tumbler?
Of things.
Like a 30-ounce Yeti?
Yeah, I got like five of those before 10 o'clock.
But is it regular or decaf?
It's regular.
Really? Well, yeah. According to, maybe Adam...
I have one before I go to bed.
Maybe Adam Evans is not much of a man compared to you, Bob.
All right.
He was a kind of a coffee wussy.
Right.
Well, this is WRLR 98.3 FM, Bob Slipke and Ted Schneider, every Tuesday from 7 to 9. Now, from 7 to 8, I'm here. Then Bob talks for like a half an hour. It's not worth listening. Then you hear music from 8:30 to 9. So if you want the good part of the show, it's usually from 7 to 8. You know, but you want to stick around an extra hour, that's cool, too. And, we should probably do a station.
Now we're going to do a little more.
Okay, go ahead.
WRLR 98.3 FM.
High school football is back for another Friday night, and we've got the Northern Lake County Conference leader, Wakanda, hosting Grays Lake North. Oh, that's not a bad matchup. Make sure you're listening right here on WRLR 98.3 FM, pregame 6:30. Kickoff at 7 o'clock. Where can you find Lake County football? Right here on WRLR 98.3 FM.
Patriotism is like charity.
It lives in the heart. Fred's Diner in Grays Lake wants to thank the military for standing tall and fighting for the red, white, and blue. Bold stripes, bright stars, and brave hearts is what this country stands for. America, without her soldiers, is like God without his angels. We don't know them all, but we owe them all. Patriotism, it runs deep at Fred's Diner in Grays Lake. This nation will remain the land of the free as long as it is the home of the brave.
Want to fight childhood asthma? Then fight it with a scrub brush and a hot soapy towel. Even in the neatest and tidiest homes, if there's so much as a crumb to eat or a drop to drink, household pests like bugs and mice will do all that they can to get it. Creepy crawlies like bugs and mice are unpleasant enough as it is, but they're more than just a nuisance for kids with asthma because they can actually trigger an asthma attack. So, give them a whole lot of nothing. Sweep up crumbs, wipe down tables, scrub dishes before they pile up in the sink, and store leftovers in plastic bags or bowls. Don't leave them so much as one tidbit or nibble, and you can stop a childhood asthma attack before it starts. Discover other simple ways to prevent an asthma attack. Call 1-866-NO-ATTACKS or visit noattacks.org, because no child should feel like a fish out of water. A public service message brought to you by the U.S. EPA, the Ad Council, and this station.
Hi, I'm Carson Beck. Do you like your weekly dose of Lake County sports? I have a show for you. Tune in to Lake County Sports Scoop right here on 98.3 WRLR on Mondays from 4 to 5 p.m., where me and my co-host, Carmel Corsair's assistant boys basketball coach, Fidel Garcia, recap and preview all things Lake County sports.
Reality's rhythms, the music the world moves to. Thursdays, 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Central Time on 98.3 FM WRLR, the voice of Lake County. With your host, David Rich. Tune in.
Pittsburgh Symphony Radio, hosted by Jim Cunningham, presents two-hour concerts with music director Manfred Honig and guest artists. Listen for interviews, historic recordings, and the latest weekly concerts from Heinz Hall. Pittsburgh Symphony Radio on WRLR is sponsored by an endowment in memory of Florence and Merwin Kine. Enjoy Pittsburgh Symphony Radio, Mondays from 8 to 10 p.m., right here on WRLR 98.3 FM, the voice of Lake County.
WRLR is community radio.
I feel much more informed with what's happening today.
When we say community, we really mean it.
It's not like corporate, it's just a good station, yeah?
We don't belong to some large corporation that makes a profit from this station.
Because I like the diversity.
And listeners won't be forced to listen to large blocks of advertising. Operations at community radio stations are made possible through grants and underwriting from companies within this area of operation. And donations, funds, and equipment, services, and time from area residents who volunteer their time to get involved.
It's as if it's my next-door neighbor talking to me, only he's on the radio instead of next door to me.
Real people just like you.
I like them. They tell it like it is.
Local focus, local news, local music, of the local people, and by the local people.
It's different than the rest of the stuff I hear.
I love the show. I listen every day.
WRLR.
Yeah, so all those foods for lowering cholesterol. You might as well just not even go into a supermarket. Just join the seagulls outside and eat what they're eating off the parking lot.
But you notice they didn't say anything about Twinkies, Bob.
Yeah.
Twinkies. Yeah.
Are Twinkies available?
Oh, yeah, they're still around.
Are they still around?
Oh, yeah, and they have deep-fried Twinkies when you go to the carnivals.
Deep-fried Twinkies. I love them. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, this is Bob Slipke and Ted Schnatter on WRLR 98.3 FM, the voice of Lake County, coming live from the Round Lake Beach Metro Station.
And this is Halloween, so I'm starting to pick up on the Halloween movies. Hocus Pocus is a classic. I think that'll stand the test of time.
And Halloween Kills comes out, I think, this Friday. Jamie Lee Curtis. It must be number, what, six or seven? How many Halloween movies are there?
I don't know. I haven't followed that. But Van Helsing with Hugh Jackman is very good.
Yeah.
And let's see. What was the other one? There was three that stand out. The one with Jeremy Rain, is it? It's Hansel and Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel.
Yeah, with Jeremy. I can't think of
Irons.
No, it's Jeremy, and he's the guy that plays the guy with the bow and arrow in the
Archer.
Archer. There you go. In the
Avengers
movies. So, and I can't think of the actress with him, but that's a really good.
Really, is that the guy that also was in the Mission Impossible movies?
Not sure. I haven't seen too many of Mission Impossible.
Well, come on, Bob, get with it. There's seven.
I got a job to do here.
Number seven is coming.
I can't watch movies all the time.
Well, Halloween is on the way, Bob. You guys need to be doing trick-or-treating this year or no?
No, our whole lives are trick-or-treats. Especially the last couple of years, we're living in a horror movie as far as I'm concerned.
So it's Halloween every day, Bob.
That's right.
Well, Bob and I try to come up with articles, as we mentioned, that you don't normally hear about. So here's 13 everyday habits that are secretly killing you.
Once again, all these things we talk about, it's up to you to explore on your own. We're just throwing meat to the lions here for information. So.
And again, Bob, I went to eatthis.com. Leah Groth. Leah. Anyway, she says, everyone knows that bad habits aren't good for your health. Bob, you have any bad habits?
Oh, that's a lie right off the bat here.
Some of your lifestyle habits, Bob, are worse than others. Bob, what's the number one lifestyle habit you need to change?
Can't talk about
it. Yeah, okay.
Let's keep that quiet.
All right, so number one, Bob.
It'll come out in an expose in somebody's book someday, so I'm not going to wreck the book sales for that.
Bob's blind. Bob, were you born blind? No, it was an acquired blindness.
So,
anyway, avoiding the doctor, Bob. Failing to see a primary care doctor or have medical screening, your blood work, your colonoscopy after 50. It's a dangerous move to make if you are worried about your health. Screening for breast cancer, colon cancer, prostate cancer. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm too scared to go now.
Now, Bob, think about it, right? When was the last time you had your PSA taken?
Well, my doctor disappeared.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Like in the...
Disappeared, gone.
Like the Purge?
I have no idea.
Was he in Soviet Russia?
No, he just... Mm. One day, the offices were closed. God knows where my medical records are.
How about his nurse?
I'll find somebody someday.
All right. Well, either way, Bob, avoiding the doctor is number one. It's a habit that could be secretly killing you. Number two, Bob.
Living a sedentary lifestyle or risking obesity. Get off your ass.
Yeah, and move.
Move it. Yeah. Soldier, move it.
Maintaining a sedentary lifestyle, Bob, is extremely hazardous. Obesity is a risk for developing hypertension, type 2 diabetes, coronary artery disease, arthritis, sleep apnea, and...
arteriosclerosis.
Which is what? You remember that is?
No, I'm not sure. I think it's a salad, but...
yeah, I think so. It's a dressing. It's very popular.
It could be a Greek cheese, too. I'm not sure.
That's what happens to Greek cheese when it's out too long.
Arteriosclerosis.
Yeah. Cut off the arteriosclerosis.
Cut off the green stuff. It'll be fine.
Anyway, Bob, if you are secretly leading a sedentary lifestyle, you're risking obesity, and it's a habit that's secretly killing you. Number three, we talked about this, maintaining poor sleep habits.
Yeah, I think sleep is good.
Yep, it is. And you know what the problem with sleep is?
You can't do it everywhere.
And you don't get a lot done. I mean, think about it. When you're sleeping, your to-do list does not get done, right?
Well, if you're sleeping, how are you going to make a to-do list?
Well, I'm saying your to-do list is done before you go to sleep.
Well, that's too tiring.
Now, do you dream like in 4K Dolby color? Panavision.
Yes, I do dream in color.
I was actually in 3D the other day. I was dreaming.
Wow.
Yeah, 4K, 3D, and the guy came out with the Panavision thing. Remember Panavision?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was incredible. Anyway.
And what were you looking at?
I can't tell you.
Was she pretty?
No. It was a secret, a top secret government thing, Bob, and I can't discuss it. And in my dream, I was sworn to secrecy. Mm-hmm. But anyway, Bob, that's a habit that's secretly killing you, maintaining poor sleep habits. What else is killing you, Bob?
Not taking care of your teeth. Ugh. Is very important.
Yes.
Keep using brushing. Gum health is so important as you get...
Yeah, I don't brush my teeth. I just brush my gums. When they bleed, I stop.
You know, and then flossing. When you get little bits of food in between, it just irritates that skin... that gum, and it just recedes away from the teeth, and then you got problems.
So you should floss, rinse, pick,
scrub,
brush, pick,
pull them out,
and then
scrub
stop
them.
Eating.
Sand, microwave them.
Yeah, filter. Stop eating. Not taking your medication. Now, Bob, non-compliance with medications is the most dangerous things you can do. Depending on the disease and the medication, non-compliance can result in a wide range of emergency conditions.
Well, here's the thing, too. Take your medications. But make sure you know what the hell you're taking, because if you take one medication, then you need another medication to take care of the side effects of that.
Right.
You're on, what do they call that? That medical tree? Or cascading nightmare.
It's a pill merry-go-round.
Right. So by the time you're 90, you've got a bushel basket of pills. It's costing the government $1,000 a day
to keep your butt alive.
I mean, you know. And just, you don't know what the hell you're taking. It's the blue pill, the red pill, the clear pill.
$1,000 a day to keep your butt alive. That's it?
Yeah.
The rest of you is dead?
That's right. That's
Number six, Bob, of everyday habits that are secretly killing you. First page, bottom.
Not following a recommended diet.
Are you on a recommended diet, Bob?
No, I recommend that I eat healthy. I'll figure it out myself.
Liar. You know now you have to eat bacon, no pop, no butter. What else? We just learned this, Bob.
Actually, I don't.
No coconut oil?
I don't do coconut oil. I don't do soda pop. No bacon. I haven't had bacon in quite a while.
But what about the fatty pork sausage, Bob?
Sausage? Now, I'll tell you what. I'll have Italian sausage once in a while.
But it's not fatty pork, right?
I don't know what's in it. You never ask what's in a sausage.
Bob, you got to ask. Is a dog? Is a human?
I think we'll
horse?
Taste that. It'll be definitely a gamey kind of taste to there.
Yeah, what, dog?
If you're not sure what you're eating, it tastes gamey, don't ask. Just let it go. Yeah.
It's okay. Not chicken.
It's very good when the chef walks by and then get the hell out of there. Yeah.
Smells kind of gamey. Meanwhile, there's no animals around like three blocks.
Look out on the street in the alley. If you don't see anything crawling around, it's probably on your table.
All right, Bob. Also, not keep up with your vaccines. Always stay on your vaccine schedule, okay? That could be secretly killing you. Like, have you gotten, will you still get polio? No. We don't get polio anymore, do we? As kids.
Yeah, who the hell knows with everybody coming over the border?
But did you get polio before as
everybody.
A kid? Remember the little circle thing?
I got the polio thing.
Okay. But anyway, keep up with your vaccines. Bob, number nine, things that are secretly killing you.
Spending too much time in the sun, especially if you're Irish.
Ah, yes, or you're an albino.
Right. Yeah, if you don't have the skin that can take a lot of sunlight, get the hell out of the sun.
But either way, Bob, failing to use sunblock can result in burns and increased risk of skin cancer.
Ugh.
I had skin cancer. I'm a skin cancer survivor.
Mm-hmm. Well, so. I've been a lifeguard, day camp counselor. I've been outside most of my life, but I'm also a Mediterranean baby, so I think I've got the skin for it.
What about an adult, though?
A what?
You said you were a Mediterranean baby.
Yeah, I still am.
Okay. But now, how about
it? Wait. No. I've got an urgent message coming in here.
Go ahead.
Stand by.
Go ahead.
WRLR. 98.3 FM.
That was early, wasn't it?
Oh.
That was early, Bob.
Well, that was an important message.
All right. But now, think about it. Now, did you ever do the nudist thing? The nudist thing out on the beach?
No.
Okay, then you have to worry about sunblock. Because, I mean, how would you put sunblock everywhere if you're in a nudist colony? Soaking up sun, right? That can be a problem.
Yeah, I tell you what, you better be careful what you're doing.
I would stay in the shade.
Dangerous territory there.
Yeah.
Gradual.
Skipping breakfast, Bob. Many people either do not have enough time or aren't hungry when they wake up. I'm hungry when I wake up.
Hmm.
I prowl outside like a panther. But anyway, skipping breakfast, Bob, according to the Journal of American College of Cardiology, is that in St. Louis? Skipping breakfast is linked with an increased risk of developing cardiovascular disease, ranked as the number one cause of death in America, according to Nikit Sampal, MD, NYC internist, and gastroenterologist. Anyway, so Zach, don't skip breakfast, okay? Get up and eat like a horse.
Yeah, so who's going to put the bag up to his face? That's what I want to know.
So you see him in the backyard with a feed bag on him.
Yeah, he's out in the backyard on all fours with a feed bag on his face. Yeah. Oh, that's Ted's son.
Yeah.
Don't go near him. He's dangerous.
He'll kick you with his shoe. All right, number 11, exercise in the heat. Bob, you ever exercise in the heat?
Yeah, it's called cutting grass.
Well no, no, it says, oh, no. Oh, exercising in the heat. I thought it says exercising in heat. I'm in heat and I'm going to go exercise.
That's that weird guy down the street.
Yeah. But exercising in the heat can lead to heat stroke, says Jennifer Conroy, certified fitness. Jennifer Conroy.
Her whole name is Jennifer Conroy, certified fitness trainer. And that's a hell of a long name.
And founder of Fluid Running. That doesn't sound good. Fluid.
Yeah.
Founder of
There's fluids. A lot of fluids on the road here.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, who's responsible for this fluid running? I am. I'm Jennifer Conroy.
You know, I give credit to anybody starting an exercise company. And hopefully most of them will be around to get the rest of us in shape.
Well, yeah, I get the certified fitness trainer, but what's a founder of fluid running? I don't know. That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, it's worth exploring.
But, Bob, during the summer, people enjoy taking advantage of the nice weather by bringing their workouts outside. You ever, like, lift weights in the outside?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do all the time. Yeah, because you know what? I'm out there with, you know, my shirt off and...
You know. And the police are coming in on you. Put that shirt on, you crazy weirdo.
Yeah. The circus must be... Looks like some farm animals must be let go. But anyway, Bob, exercise in the heat, you could get a lot of things like sunstroke, right?
Hmm.
You could get heat stroke. You could get just plain old stroke.
Hmm.
Yeah, so just watch out exercising in the heat.
Or don't exercise in the heat.
Yeah. Wait till it's cold out. Wait till there's like snow on the ground. Then get out there.
Yeah, then cut the grass.
Yeah. Get out there and get frostbite as you're out there lifting weights. Bob, number 12 of the things that are everyday habits that are secretly killing.
This is really a good one. Of all the things we've talked about here, eating a large dinner at night, I think, really taxes you.
Okay.
I think the biggest meal of the day for me is lunch.
Okay.
If I eat it. If I have a big breakfast... And I'm not that hungry in the middle of the day. I'll wait and have an early dinner, but I'll just snack at night now. I'm just not that hungry at night.
Well, here's the thing, Bob. It says eat like a queen for breakfast and a princess for lunch and a bird for dinner. So wait a second. You can eat like a queen for breakfast, a princess for lunch, and a bird for dinner. It's kind of sexist.
I'm not sure about wearing a dress for breakfast, but
yeah.
A princess for lunch.
I'm at the Queen's here. Bring me my crumpets.
And dress like a bird for dinner. I don't know.
Sit on a telephone wire and poop on your neighbor's car.
That's right. Actually, I'd probably enjoy that because I'm so bored.
So yeah, anyway.
Too bad.
So I think it would be like a king for breakfast, Bob, and a prince for lunch and bird for dinner.
Right.
And lastly, Bob, if you want a secret habit or a habit that's killing you secretly, number 13, smoking. Well, of course, that's not...
Smoking.
There's no secret there. It's killing you. Of course it's killing you. What? You know what? And you know what the problem is, Bob? Smoking is a powerful addiction. I know. I stopped in like third grade. It was tough. It was a tough habit. But you know what? I was out playing dodgeball, just couldn't keep up with the kids. I was wheezing, you know. I couldn't do the laps on the track.
The nuns taught us how to smoke, so I don't know.
Did they really? Okay, but Bob, it's not a habit that's secretly killing you. Look at the package. It says all the things it'll cause, right?
Death. You're going to die if you buy this product.
Yeah, you're...
Talk about your fear.
Your tongue's going to fall off.
Oh, my God.
All right, well, Bob, you want to do the music and then... No, we're going to do it. We should do that because that was the end of an article, guys. Okay.
It was?
Yeah, it was. So go ahead. I'm waiting.
Let's
patiently.
Try this.
Go ahead. Bop, 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 bop.
It's official. We're moving on to a new topic. All right.
So, Kim Komando, if you remember her, she does a lot of online safety. Well, I thought it's time to go back to some online safety, Bob. Here's 12 things you should never do online. Okay.
Buy anything.
Yeah, no, but number one, don't give correct answers when setting up security questions. Now, that's a good answer. It's a good, you know why? Because here's the point. You write them down someplace in a secret location, right? But, like, you do answers that aren't you because a lot of times then people will know your first car, your dog's name, you know, your birthday, the color of your hair, or whatever. So when they give you, like, favorite food, say something like, you know, I don't know, spinach or kale or something. lie.
Those are my favorite foods.
Okay, well, for most people, it's not, okay? like your first crush, you know, say some orange or something. I mean, the point is, you need to make sure these answers aren't true, so if anybody does know you, they will not know the answers to the question, your security questions, but you would know the answers. Make sense?
Hmm. Wow.
So, yeah, don't give correct answers when setting up security questions. Only you know the answer anyway, Bob. Hmm. So you can say anything you want. Like, mother's maiden name, what would you say?
Oh, Smith.
Exactly. No, that's too common.
Hmm.
I'd make it like Podgorski or something.
Podgorski.
Yeah.
You gotta be able to spell it, too.
Well, you write it down in your secret location.
Podgorski.
Podgorski. What else, Bob? Yes. Number two, things you should never do online, according to Kim Komando.
Did an ad send you to a new site? Don't click any download button.
No! Don't!
No.
Stay away!
Don't fall for fake posts either. That's a good one.
Fake posts.
If you get an email solicitation to participate in a survey, forget about it.
Yeah, or a money-making opportunity, don't sign up. Don't click. Bottom line is, Bob, you get an email and you don't know who it's from, don't touch it.
Don't
delete
touch it. Throw it out.
Yeah, exactly. Don't skip two-factor authentication. That's really good. So when you sign into your bank account, they send you a code. And it's only coming to your phone. Without that code, you're not getting in. Facebook. Banking. Whatever you do, two-step authentication. Make them send you a code, and it's to your phone. It's already been set up in the system.
Wow.
So if anybody hacks in, they get your password. Ah! Two-step authentication. The code is not going to them. It's going to me.
That's good.
Unless they have your cell phone and your password, you're okay.
Hmm.
So Kim Komando says, what else, Bob?
Don't reuse passwords or password formulas.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that makes sense. You change your password for a lot of things or what?
Yeah, I do. Every month I change passwords.
But I mean, you make them different for different accounts.
I got passwords upon passwords.
Okay, yeah. And I make them tough.
And you know what? I've made them so tough, I don't even go to the websites anymore.
Yeah, that's right. Here's an example for work, right? We have a random code generator for each person. And it puts a random 8-digit code out every 60 seconds just to log into the system to start with.
Wow.
Once you get in, then to log into your own system, your own part of the LAN, it's a 12-digit code and can have no word in the English language, and that changes every 3 months.
Wow.
Yeah. And like with my phone and my watch, I have to change the passcode to get in every 3 months. And it's a 6-digit passcode.
Telling me more, you American dog.
I'm just saying. So don't use public Wi-Fi. Of course, never use public Wi-Fi. Because you don't know if you're hooked up to Starbucks Wi-Fi or someone that is impersonating the Starbucks Wi-Fi.
Yeah, and you just don't know.
Exactly. And also, Bob, don't fight on social media. You know why?
No.
Meet him in the alley instead. Why would you find him? Cameras. No, I guess what they're saying, a lot of people, social media makes us depressed. No kidding. Angry and isolated. Bob, have you been depressed, angry, and isolated lately?
No.
Oh, because you're on social media. See?
Yeah, I don't go on a social media thing.
But during the pandemic, like it's over, we believe social media would bring us together, but really we got sucked into scrolling through endless timelines, comments, and arguments. You know, and that's part of the problem is that people are either left or they're right, and nobody wants to listen to anybody. So,
and cognitive dissonance. That's right.
Is that what it is?
Yep.
Does that mean you have to wear depends?
No. It's cognitive dissonance means you're just looking for the things that'll back up your beliefs.
Exactly. And you, if you want to see a good thing, Netflix had a thing called The Social Dilemma. That spells out the problem, what's going on in our society today with social media. Interesting. Like Facebook as an example.
Oh.
Facebook makes money how, Bob?
By personal information of all the users.
And the more information you put out there, pictures, information, you know, events you've done, and the more you click, the more money they make.
Wow.
So think about it, right? They make no money themselves. It's all the people that get sucked into that. That's how they make their money.
You know what I would do? I think everybody should just post phony information. You post pictures here of somebody else's family.
So you know what, Bob? Next week when we do our show,
yeah,
let's post two people that have nothing to do with the show.
Right. Yeah.
We'll get two random people outside.
Yeah, pick two pictures.
Yeah. Bob, number eight of things you should stop doing online.
Number eight?
Number eight.
Don't post sensitive photos. Oh, yeah, right. Yeah. Keep the nude photos on your phone.
Yeah, and Bob, and by the way, stop sending me the nude photos, too. That's not, you know, I don't want to see, like, your honeymoon pictures.
We're going to Utah? Damn. Who the hell was I sending?
You know, a couple of times I looked, I had to turn the phone this way and that way. I said, what the heck is
that?
What's
wrong with Bob now?
Yeah, what is he sending me there?
It looks here's like, another one, too. You're talking about don't post vacation photos. Or updates while you're gone.
Right.
Ta-da.
Yeah.
Oh, he must not be home now.
Yeah, we're in Virginia. Come on. And number
we
10,
Bob.
We won't
be back for 3 months.
Or?
Diagnose yourself on WebMD or similar sites.
How many times have you Googled your symptoms and go, you know what? I have bubonic plague.
Oh, blast.
No? You've never done that?
No, never done that.
Oh, well, I've done it a few times because, you know, you get like
you
a little...
You misdiagnosed yourself?
Well, no, you get a little sore somewhere and it doesn't heal and you're kind of like, oh, that just showed up. What is that? All right, Bob. Well, this is Bob Slipke and Ted Schneider on WRLR 98.3 FM, the Voice of Lake County, coming to live from the Round Lake Beach Metro Station. We got about 5 minutes left, Bob. You know what we should do?
Sleep?
Nope. Not about some
sleep's important. You just said so.
Well, it is important, Bob. But no, I think what we should probably do is do a quick little recap of what we've talked about tonight, just so that those that join late know.
I don't like tests.
No. Now, Bob, so name three foods that'll definitely is bad for you if you have high cholesterol and you can't look at your papers. Three foods.
Bacon.
Yes.
Coconut oil.
Yes.
Trans fats.
No, that wasn't on there.
Smoking.
True. And here's a bonus question. What's the fourth thing? It's made with processed carbohydrates, refined carbohydrates.
Oh, white bread.
That's it. All right, Bob, you were paying attention.
Ding, 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 ding.
Tell me more. Now, Bob, also, give me, how about quiz me? How about some everyday habits that are secretly killing us?
All right. Give me three of those. That's
one,
a good idea.
Avoiding the doctor. Remember, you got to go get regular tests, blood work. Have them check your prostate digitally.
You get your hands off of me.
We talked again, poor sleep habits, right? That's not secretly killing you. Everyone knows about that.
Everybody's working two jobs. There is no time to sleep.
We talked also about not taking care of your teeth, your gnarlies, right?
Yeah.
Floss, rinse, pick.
Bad breath.
Yeah, and brush.
And comb your tongue.
Yes. And lastly, Bob, we talked about some things you should never do online, and what were they?
Oh, post pictures of you're on vacation?
Yes.
Or those naughty pictures that you should never publish anywhere.
Which they probably will get taken down, won't they? Looks like, yeah.
And then with the ads. If you get some ad,
click.
Telling you how to, you can make easy money from home.
Yeah.
Don't click any downloads, whatever you do. Don't do it.
And the other thing she talked about is the passwords. Make sure they're not.
Passwords, yeah.
Yeah, make up the answers.
Right.
And lastly, Bob, we had talked about seven reasons why you might feel heavy and tired, and it's not because you're a big old person.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, so, Bob, you remember that?
No.
Well, one was about sleep. Again, sleep is a theme here, Bob.
Sleep is important. That's right.
You don't get your sleep, you could be heavy and tired. We also talk about lack of exercise and poor nutrition and hydration. Because remember,
we are what we eat. I agree.
Exactly, Bob. So if you eat a bunch of crap.
Is that a naughty word? We're not supposed to say
that. No, I think that's okay. Lastly, Bob, I think we talked about just in general what WRLR 98.3 FM does. And Bob, why don't you remind our listeners what WRLR 98.3 FM is about?
Well, we are local producers in your neighborhoods.
Yep.
And this is an excellent opportunity. It's community access radio.
Mm-hmm.
And you will find a variety of producers doing different kinds of shows all over our program schedule. Check out our website. And
at WRLR.FM. And you can, as Bob mentioned, we have high school sports. Rusty and his team is back out there doing high school sports.
And the action in the area is very good. So if you're into local sports, go for it. Check out what's going on here. If you can't get to a school event and support them, at least you can find out what's going on here.
And we have, like, So Sweet with Cheryl Dunlap. We've got, of course, we mentioned the Info Explorers, Bob Slipke and Ted Schneider. We also have The Big Show with Rusty Silber. Bacon Bits is on. We have the Pittsburgh Symphony Concert. We also have Northern Lights Mix on Thursday evening. The Beatles Box. Peter Marsham is on. We have a Children's Hour now. We've got Word of Mouth. We have the Supersonic 70s, the Paul Baker Weekly Edition. Bottom line is, we have so much programming, Bob. It's a variety of music, talk, and then just, again, variety in general.
Humor. Don't forget humor.
Ah, yes, Bob. Yeah. But anyway, Bob, 8:30, 8:39, what's on for the music?
You know what? I'm going for the easy music listening, 8:30 to 9, so we can all calm down and relax.
All right.
Other than that, I've got some information. Once again, I'm looking for stuff that's going to keep us a strong middle class. And one of the events of the year, past couple of years, is this whole flu thing and what's going on around the world. We're seeing some pushback now. Southwest pilots are, it looks like they're doing a, what do they call it? It's not a strike. It's a...
slowdown?
A slowdown, a call-in. They're calling in sick to fight these mask mandates, or no, the vaccine mandates.
That's so what the whole Southwest...
Police are resigning or waiting to get fired. Hospital workers, there is definitely something going on. People reacting to the vaccine mandates. And it's very interesting.
But interesting you say that. I saw an article in the... Oh, don't tell me. It was in the Tribune, and they talked about how the mandates are actually working to get more people vaccinated.
Really? That,
yeah. The Tribune last Sunday showed an article on more people getting vaccinated by based on the mandates, but it also says...